Mr. Speaker, this is just another long list that you've witnessed today and really all through this administration of bureaucratic oversight and fines to administer on the taxpayer. What my amendment does is prohibit use of funds to implement, finalize, or enforce a proposed rule entitled Enhanced Disclosures by Certain Investment Advisors and Investment Companies about Environmental, Social, and Government Investment Practices. On May 25, 2022, the SEC proposed rules that mandate additional disclosures for funds incorporating or contemplating ESG factors in their investment strategies. If adopted, the rule would reflect a significant shift in the SEC's current disclosure regime for private fund sponsors by focusing disclosures on a particular targeted aspect of the investment process. The primary purpose of this rule is to address the risk of greenwashing and furnish investors with more comprehensive information regarding ESG strategies. I reserve the balance of my time.
Gentleman reserves. For what purpose does the gentleman from Pennsylvania seek recognition?
Claim time in opposition.
The gentleman is recognized.
Well, Mr. Chair, I rise in opposition to this amendment as well. Contrary to the misrepresentations made by environmental, social, and government's opponents, the SEC disclosure rule on ESG investments takes no position on the merits of these approaches. The rule does not define ESG or stipulate any particular approach to it. Instead, this is a rule that requires for those who make such investments the disclosure of information about how ESG is defined and implemented in applicable investment portfolios. The rule will offer increased transparency for investors and protect them from exaggerated or unfounded claims related to ESG investments being made. Now, if it passes, my friend from South Carolina's amendment would leave investors in the dark and leave them vulnerable to getting misled or bamboozled about ESG claims. I strongly oppose this amendment, and I do urge a no vote. I reserve the balance of my time.
Gentleman from Pennsylvania reserves. The gentleman from South Carolina is recognized.
Well, I take issue with my good friend on the opposite aisle. In fact, I would note the Supreme Court's recent decision in West Virginia versus EPA raises concerns about the Commission's ability to implement both this proposal and the broader climate disclosure rule under the major questions doctrine. This is over excessive. Excessively broad, intricate, overly prescriptive, vague. And again, this is just another bureaucratic commission set up to fleece the taxpayers and fleece the people that made this country. I urge the adoption of my amendment, and I yield the balance of my time.
The gentleman yields. The gentleman from Pennsylvania is recognized.
Hi, Mr. Chair. For the reasons previously stated, this amendment is opposed, and I yield back.
Gentleman yields. The question is now on the amendment offered by the gentleman from South Carolina. Those in favor.